We did some visual inspection and explored various PCB testing methods for PCBs in the last video. In this video, we'll use similar methods to test the quality of PCB produced by PCB Power Market, who manufacture the PCB locally both in India as well in the US. I received the package after 10 days from the date I placed the order, where it took 7 days to manufacture and approximately 3 days for shipping. Well, you can reduce the production time to 3 or 5 days, but that's going to skyrocket your production costs like crazy. So in my case, I stuck to 7 days and the PCB cost me close to $33, including shipping. And when I compare these prices to the other fabrication plants, it stands in a pretty reasonable position, considering I had a hassle-free experience with the whole order and the shipping process. The first thing you would have noticed is a color difference. This is one of the unique features that I have seen in the order process, where we can select a different solder mask for the back and the front layer. This might be also available with other manufacturers, but you need to specifically request this over a mail to the fabrication plant. But in this case, the option is available by default at their order page. Now coming to the second point, you would have noticed I had a letter kind of a package when I was unboxing. Well, this is a test report for the PCB. That's amazing, because this contains a detailed test done on manufactured PCB while it was in the fabrication plant. And it's very similar to the test list that I have. Well, of course, with better terminologies. I spoke to the people at PCB Power to confirm a few of the technologies they use to produce the PCB. And it seems like they use top industry standard techniques to produce their PCB. So with this information, I'll walk you through our test list and see how the PCBs perform. Let's start with the silk layer. It looks pretty good. But it has some fading and discontinuity, especially with the logo and custom graphics. But surprisingly, I did not notice this issue on any of my previous orders. So I contacted PCB Power to see what went wrong. After going back and forth for a while, they figured out what the issue was with the QC team. The minor errors were due to the vibration of the printing head during the silk layer printing process, and they assured me this is just a random error and can be fixed with small steps during production. They also shared some real-time pictures of PCBs from their production line, which did not face any issues with graphics or logos, but unfortunately I won't be able to share those pictures online. Anyway, apart from this, the quality of silk screen is acceptable as per IPC standard, as the text look pretty good and there is no distortion or fading on any other part of the silk layer. If you like to learn more about IPC standard and why it is followed, please check out this article we have written on IPC. For solder paste, this particular batch went through the same HASL process. And everything seems good. No oxidation, no clumping, no excess solder, or dryness from improper finish. Solder mask was particularly very interesting on this PCB. They don't cover the entire board with the solder mask, instead they cover only the area that has copper pores and tracks. Initially, I thought this could easily affect the quality of the mask by introducing peeling, lifting, or making it easy for moisture to get in. But surprisingly, it's pretty well bonded compared to the other PCBs, and it was sort of a scratch resistant and required more force to scrape the solder mask. Apparently, this turned out to be one of the best solder masks, where I could find no issues with lifting, peeling, cracks, pinholes, and also it was really good at rippling solder and it was scratch resistant. So overall, it was a perfect solder mask for the price. For the traces and removal of unwanted copper, PCB Power uses the process called wet etching. And I couldn't find any issues on traces like discontinuity, scratches, corrosion, or poor adhesion. Also, it did not have any breaks or fractures. Overall, the traces had uniform thickness and width with no open or short circuit in the traces. I don't think we can catch errors on traces easily, as these PCBs run through the electrical test before they leave the factory. Next, the FR4 quality of this PCB is really good. No signs of delamination, cracks, warping, or uneven surfaces. Overall, it is very rigid. This could easily handle larger components and mechanical mounting holes. Finally, during the assembly, I did not notice any heat stress. The traces weren't damaged, none of the pads were lifting off, and overall had very good soldering joints to the components. PCB from PCB Power Market performed really well in all the tests, and there weren't many mistakes or defects. Anyway, the final conclusion after the test, I would give a solid 9 out of 10 for the PCB, And if you'd like to know why the particular tests were performed on each layer, I'll drop a link in the description which will help you understand how each layer is manufactured and how they affect the quality of printed circuit boards. Finally, please let us know if you enjoyed these kind of content and if you'd like us to dive more deeply into various testing methods. And if you like to follow up more PCB content, make sure you're subscribed to this channel. Also, if you have any questions regarding these videos or any topics related to PCB, you're free to drop a question in the PCBCupid Q&A section. Until then, keep learning and keep creating.